a brand ambassador, talk to the audience about what a brand ambassador does. Because I think a lot of times people think a brand ambassador is just like, I show up, I market a little bit, posters, T-shirt, whatever, and then I'm out. Like, I know it's more than that. So can you just give me an idea of what your day-to-day would be and before COVID and then now with COVID?
Well, the role of the brand ambassador for me, it wasn't something that was like all the way year round. It was mostly during the time when we had beer festivals. So I'd basically be like definitely the person who's going to be pouring, kind of the face of the brewery. And what that allowed me to do was, you know, basically really engage with people at some of these festivals that normally couldn't come all the way down the barrier or wanted to try our beers.
I see what you're saying.
But also network and like meet different people and able to do like offshoot things like, you know, charity events and whatnot. You know what I mean?
Nice. So let's jump into the first beer, man. We like I said, we got plenty to talk about. I want to talk about your history, just being in the Bay Area in general,
because yeah,
you know some people that I grew up with or was around. So that's great. We're from my Oakland Tech days, so we'll talk about that. But let's start off with the we got the exclusive. So we might as well start off with the exclusive first. This is the Oktoberfest right here.
That's what we're drinking right now.
Yeah. So and Diggs is gonna pull up the specs on it because we. Is it Ryan who's a head brewer?
Yeah. Ryan is our head brewer.
Shout out Ryan. He's not here today, but we're gonna get with you, Ryan. We're gonna get with you soon. So this is the Oktoberfest, basically a German style lager, if I'm not mistaken, but correct me if I'm wrong, Diggs.
Yeah.
You see the color on this, man, is definitely
golden.
Yeah, golden. Just kind of in between a amberish, but more so golden. Mm-hmm. The nose on it, of course. Get that good Vienna, almost Vienna lager smell. You get a lot
very
of malts.
Caramely.
Yeah, very caramely, very malty coming off of that thing. So let's cheers to that. Cheers out here. And like I learned from Justin, one for the house.
Yeah, yes, sir. And it's clean.
Oh, yeah.
5.5%. This is what I'm drinking. Way more lagers because those IPAs just killing my gut, man.
Yes.
Trying to keep my karate body going.
Oh, man, I ain't had that and I don't know how long. So when it comes to like drinking lagers, because I know we talked off mic about that. You going more focused, not just because of COVID, not being able to hit the gym, but I think also, and you can correct me if I'm wrong on this, I think a lot of brewers and people who work at breweries and just a brewery staff in general, like they don't drink the heavier beers like just throughout the day. And even off shift, they're not trying to do the 9% or the 10 or 11% type of beers. They're really trying to stick around that 4.5 to maybe 5.5-6% type of thing. So is that what you're drinking on a daily, even when you working here, or how does that go?
Drinking a little bit of everything.
Okay.
But more so, yeah, a lot more lagers. Just because as I've been in the industry longer, I appreciate lagers a little bit more.
Gotta respect them. Gotta show the respect to the lager. You know,
that's just how I feel in general. And, you know, IPAs are everywhere. Just like, you know, they're changing so much drastically. And to me, how good a brewery is really all their lovers. You know what I mean?
Gotcha.
But, you know, I like my hazy IPAs. I like my West Coast dank IPAs. Mm-hmm. But, you know, for a while, that's all I was drinking. Right. And I was just killing my mouth, man.
Like, gotcha.
My palate was just...
Just being destroyed.
Just being destroyed, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, especially when it's hot, these lagers, you know, I could run through these. When I'm drinking those IPAs, I get...
You said you got to sit back.
I get sleepy, man.
That's right, man.
I get tired.
It's heavy with that ABV. Now, have you seen a change in hazies and IPAs from, like, when you were drinking them in the beginning to now? Because it just seems like it's more so focused on how the hop brings in flavor and less of, like, just let me hit you with this alpha acid explosion on your palate to where it destroys it. Like,
yeah, before what I was noticing, like, you know, going back to like old school, was like the curveball IPA was like,
man,
the super
hoppy
hot bomb bitter. It wasn't hazy or juicy. It just was straight, like just a straight IPA. And then I noticed a lot of people like used to come in and be like, I want the D-Nog. Denogonizer, you know what I'm saying? They want that gasoline.
Yeah, that Drake special.
And over time, you know, I'm definitely seeing like a switch to hazy IPAs. Even like certain breweries that I thought would never do a hazy IPA are starting to do them. And then I'm starting to see like lately, like, people kind of go back to, like, the old school or try to refrain from doing hazy IPAs.
Gotcha.
Like, Harmonic, for example, refuse to do a hazy IPA.
Yep.
Not that they feel like it's bad or anything, you know, but they want to stay in their lane.
Mm.
You know, clean lagers and really good IPAs is what their niche was. You know what I mean?
Gotcha. So let's jump into this one right here, man. It's been sitting here for a while since we first got here.
Which one is
the
that?
The Especial, the Mexican lager.
My Especial.
Oh, you finished yours up, man. You might as well just take the one. Take the one you was gonna give to Pops.
Okay,
yeah, it's our cheers to that, to the table. I mean, to the house. Now this one definitely has some just a clean finish of a lager. You get the notes of the corn. I'm trying to think of some other notes. I didn't pull up the list, but what most people do with a Mexican style lager is what you're getting with this. I do love the color on this one though.
Same.
It's not even like a light. It doesn't look like a lager. It's more golden, almost like a hazy, but almost like an IPA, but not really. But that color is really nice.
Yeah. And it's soft.
Yeah, very soft. And the nose on that is good. The ABV, let me reach over here to this can.
Yep.
Where's the ABV at? Oh, snap. I didn't get it. But I'm going to say maybe 4.5 to 5 probably on this one.
It's reaching around 5.
Okay.
Wow. Really good, too. Right now, that's like one of our top sellers is the Temescal Especial.
Chris, man. That's Chris. You know, it's good.
Ryan did a real good job on this. Clean. I killed about 24 of those last week when I was camping.
Oh, wow, okay. Oh, you was camping, all right.
I was camping.
No, that's definitely good.